Hi, here's another little get ready with me video as I get ready for a party this evening. Now, I'm not very good at gathering my thoughts and speaking while I'm doing the makeup, but while the video's going on. So I'm just gonna start recording from here, just the video, and add my voiceover later on. So here we go. As always, in step one, I washed my face with a face wash, and now I'm applying this vitamin C toner from Pixie Beauty. I've used Pixie's retinol tonic some months back, which was okay, nothing great. And on alternate days, I use their award-winning glow tonic in my skincare routine. Last year, I used to use the alcohol-free Witch Hazel Toner by Thayers. So step two basically is cleaning the face with a toner and cotton pad before applying serums and moisturizers. And despite having washed my face just now, this is what comes off on the cotton pad. Step three, I apply a serum and eye cream, but I've run out of both and need to go buy some. So skipping to step four, I'm applying this L'Oreal Age Perfect Nourishing Face Moisturizer and applying a little extra because it's getting cooler out here and my skin is getting drier, so I'm massaging it well onto my skin. Taking care of the neck area too and applying a little extra on my forehead and ears where it gets more dry and flaky. And here goes the Vaseline Lip Balm on my lips to keep them moisturized until it's time for lipstick. Step 5, I'm applying this Smashbox primer that's meant to smooth and blur. Primer makes a big difference in makeup application. It helps the foundation go on smoothly and stay on longer too. I use the same primer on my eyelids instead of a separate eyeshadow primer, so I apply the primer well all over my face and usually give it a couple of minutes to settle. In that time, I set up the cosmetics on the table that I want to use or get the accessories ready for the clothes I'm going to wear. Step 6, I'm applying this e.l.f. color correcting stick in a deep orange color. In my previous makeup videos, I've talked a few times about why to use a color corrector, which color to use, where to apply it, and what my problem areas are. I'll avoid repeating the same thing again, so go check the previous videos out. After dabbing it a little, and while I let the color corrector also settle, let me show you the makeup products laid out in front of me that I plan on using today. I have only these three eyeshadow palettes, so any look I create comes from a combination of colors right here. I have a video of my vanity table showing exactly what I keep in my skincare and makeup drawers. If you want to see the small collection of makeup I have, go check that video out too. Step 7, I'm applying foundation. This one is from Too Faced Born This Way in the shade Caramel. And you see me applying it this way because I got this little sample from the Sephora store to try it out before buying the whole bottle. I'm gently spreading it using fingers instead of using a brush because half the product gets lost in the brush. Now I'm using my trusty and damp Real Techniques blending sponge that works like a beauty blender. Pat pat and bounce bounce the sponge all over the face to make the foundation look flawless. It does take 2 minutes to do this properly. Remember to use a damp sponge, which means run the sponge in water or soak it in a glass of water and let it expand and then squeeze out all the water. Then use it to apply foundation, concealer, powder, contour. I mean, I love an efficient all-in-one product. I'm spraying the setting spray once along with the foundation because it's going to be a very long evening and because I'll be performing a dance too, so I want everything to really stay put. Step 8, I'm applying the concealer, also from Too Faced Born This Way in the shade Warm Sand. Using a clean side of the blending sponge, I'm dabbing the concealer well all around my eye area. And while the setting spray is still wet on my face, I'm using the foundation side of the sponge and using bouncy dab dab motion to make sure the setting spray reaches everywhere and sets the foundation in place. I'm applying the Maybelline concealer in shade medium on my forehead, bridge of the nose, above and below the lips. Why two different concealers, do you wonder? Two reasons. One, because I bought this one without trying it out and that's why it turns out the shade is too light for under my eyes. Secondly, because it tingles on my eye area, so I'm using it up in the areas that need concealer and those that I need to highlight anyway. Step 9, I'm applying LA Girl's HD Pro Concealer in the shade Espresso as a contour. I've talked more about contouring in my previous makeup videos, so I'm thinking of skipping saying the same stuff again. But here are 2 points I can add to what I have already said. First, how do you choose a contour shade? So it's said to choose a concealer shade 1 or 2 shades lighter than the foundation, and contour is supposed to be 2 shades darker than your foundation shade. Here I'm using the foundation side of the same blending sponge to blend out the contour, first starting from jawline and then forehead because these cover more area, Then moving on to the sides of the nose, because it needs the pointy side of the sponge for precision. And then to the sides of the cheeks towards the high point of the ears. Now the second point I wanted to mention was, a liquid contour like this takes a little more precision in blending so that it doesn't leave obvious lines on the face. You could start with a powder matte contour if you're a beginner at contouring. And because contouring is supposed to lift and define the face, I keep a finger inclined as a guideline to not let the contour go below that. Step 10, I'm applying the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder, dropping some on the lid and picking it up with an almost clean side of the blending sponge. I'm dabbing the powder under the eyes, over the eyelids, forehead, cheeks, basically everywhere where the contour hasn't been applied. I love this loose powder that's so light and sets the foundation and doesn't make the face look whitish or cakey and has no shimmer in it too. I have used CoverGirl loose powder in the past, which was good. I have used Lakme loose as well as the compact powder from India, which were okay. And I also use Maybelline Face Studio Master Fix Setting Plus Perfecting Loose Powder, which is good. But this one from Laura Mercier, although pricey, takes the cake. And I prefer how a blending sponge pats it well instead of using a powder brush to apply powder. Just a personal preference. I'm applying a little extra under my eyes before I start on the eyeshadow so that it's easier to brush out any eyeshadow fallouts. Step 11, I'm applying the Golden Eyeshadow from the Spur Cosmetics Festival Palette all over my eyelid. Now, this shade here is called Psychedelic, but the name doesn't matter because if you understand the concept of eyeshadows, you can use anything from what you have. I'm patting on more Golden Eyeshadow because I'm going to mix the blue shade from the little Maybelline palette that I have. My dress today is a golden top with light green skirt and a long pink scarf. For those who understand Hindi, that's a golden blouse, a green color lehenga, and a pink color dupatta. Now, I don't have green color in any of my eyeshadow palettes, but we all know that mixing blue and yellow makes green. So I'm blending a little of the blue and a lot of the golden to make the green look similar to the green of my dress. I'm patting the eyeshadow on almost the outer half of my eyelid and leaving the inner half golden. I'm going to apply some shimmer on the eyelids later, but for now I'm done with achieving the color I want, so I'm brushing out the fallouts and the powder from under the eyes. Step 12, I'm applying the Epic Ink Eyeliner from NYX. First, I draw the outer lines from the eye and fill it in. Having an outline helps me fill it easier than extending the line a little at a time because I tend to make more blunders and then end up cleaning a lot. Also, when my friend mentioned that she's not comfortable putting an eyeliner, I told her two things. One is to have a support, put the elbow somewhere where the hand can be still. Second, what works for me is to draw a little line, then blink my eyes each time instead of putting the eyeliner at one go and messing it up. Also, it's always better to start with a thin line close to the eyelash, then make it thick as you go, depending on how you want. And as I said in one of my previous videos, whether you make dots and connect the dots, dashes and connect the line, or fill in the shape, applying eyeliner just takes practice. And only practice makes progress. Step 13, I'm applying the Maybelline Great Lash Mascara in black. I roll the mascara wand as I apply so that it also separates the lashes as I go instead of having clumpy lashes. Step 14, I'm applying the L'Oreal lipstick in shade 590 called Blushing Berry. I love how subtle, beautiful pink it is and it suits my skin tone so well. Step 15, I'm applying the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula, which I could have applied in step 12 as well, right after brushing off any eyeshadow fallouts. I've talked about bronzer in my previous makeup videos, so do check that out too. Step 16, I'm applying the eyebrow pencil, quickly filling up any sparse areas of my eyebrows without drawing any extra lines on top or bottom, because it's a personal preference that I don't like thick eyebrows. And then I'm using the brush on the other side of the pencil to brush the eyebrows and fill it in. Applying foundation all over the face makes the eyebrows lighter in color. So if you haven't already started doing this, start defining your eyebrows because it's a game changer. I also realized I didn't add a pink shade on my eyes to match the pink on my attire. So I'm using a smudge brush to apply the pink on my lower lash line. Then I'm adding a little blue on the outer corner of the lower lash line to blend the pink and the green with a little blue. Step 17, I'm applying the blush from NYX in the shade Bitten. This is the only blush I've had since over a year, and I really need to try some more, but I'm still waiting for this to finish. But some products just seem to last forever, you know? Well, I'm not complaining. It's value for money for sure. Step 18, I'm applying the creamy highlighter from Girlactic and taking both the golden and pink onto the highlighting brush. I'm applying the highlighter on the high points of my cheek, towards the sides of the forehead, on the bridge of the nose, brushing on the middle of the forehead, on the top and bottom of my lips, and whatever is remaining on the brush goes on the neck. I also press a paper towel between my lips and then put another layer of lipstick because it helps my lipstick last long even after I eat food. I'm also applying a black pencil eyeliner on the lower lash line. This one is from Pixie by Petra. Eyeshadow, mascara, eyeliner, everything is fine. But the way the eyes look so defined with a liner on the lower lash line is unmatchable. For the last thing on my eyes, I'm adding glitter using my ring finger right in the middle of both the eyeshadows. Disclaimer first, the box says to keep this glitter entirely clear of the eye area, so what I'm doing here is a personal preference. I've had this glitter pot from MAC Cosmetics since over 7 years now, and I swear this thing just never seems to end. This glitter, which doesn't seem to have a shade name or number, but it says Reflects Antique Gold, is my favorite to add a little glamour in an instant on my face or when I use it as body glitter. It's got this gorgeous shine. Now, I don't know if this has an expiration date, but I'm pretty sure it's going to last until I grow old and have grandchildren. Alright, done with my makeup. Now I'm choosing between these two earrings and picking one. Adding accessories, checking for any lipstick on my teeth, brushing off any glitter that fell under my eyes. Happy with my look, and now finishing up with this NYX setting spray that gives a long-lasting dewy finish. I spritz it 3 times on the center and thrice on the sides to cover the entire area of the face. Like I said, I'll be dancing on stage with my friends and I need my makeup to last well until the end of the party tonight. While I try to find a good angle to show you my final makeup, I hope you are enjoying these makeup videos and the little get ready with me and the little tips and tricks that I'm sharing. If you are, comment or message to let me know, because if I see people learning and liking what I'm sharing, only then I'll continue with these videos. Because if I don't get any feedback, then I don't see a point in making these, you know what I mean? Well, that's all I have for now. But, oh wait, bonus. Here are some pictures from the party. I added hair extensions to make this hairstyle, and what a huge difference it makes to the appearance, isn't it? Let me know if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions. All kinds of feedbacks are welcome, and thanks for watching. Bye!